Right, okay, we are live. I don't even know whether I'm blind guy trying to find out where the commanders are. Right, okay. Up there, right, okay, as promised. This is about this. Right, let's turn all the effects off at first so I can tell you a little bit about it. Doing a performance with a 99 other people making up the 100 Murmerists in June. One of the things that we've been asked to bring along, or various people have been asked to bring along, are certain props. The prop I was asked to bring along was a fork or a pitchfork or something like that. A kind donation of a broken garden fork yielded this, and I thought, well, rather than it just being a prop, I'll make it a musical instrument as well. So here we have garden fork. Attached to the garden fork, I found three little brass rods, which have been attached by various plumbing things there and made safe by good old duct tape. And after about an hour and a half of trying to dig the rotten wood out of there, I utilised the holes to insert some springs as well. So basically now we have still a garden fork, I suppose, if you wanted to use it in that way. But it's also, it's got a lovely sort of. So there you go. Yeah, wonderful. Very resonant. I can feel it humming through my fingers there. So the secret here is, sorry, around the back here is a contact mic, which is clattering about and attached into my trusty old slightly noisy PV guitar amp tucked just out of sight there. On tap I also have, love this pedal, it's made by Dan Electro, it's called a Real Echo. As the graphics might suggest, it's to basically pretends to be an old tape delay, and fun is to be had with that. Also a little reverb pedal called Ambience, which is, it sort of combines an echo and a reverb in one pedal, which makes it sound really nice. So it goes from to, so maybe a little bit strong there, but hey, whatnot. And yeah, this is just wonderful. So I will just start performing. Thank you. So yeah, I call that the untuning fork. I hope that wasn't too torturous.